Coming up next, it's a UFC heavyweight division collision.
Well, this is about as decorated a kickboxer as has come into this division in some time, DC. And if we get a kickboxing match tonight, he ain't losing.
He is a championship-level kickboxer, a guy that can stand in the pocket and trade and kick and punch with anyone. He's constantly throwing things from as close as you can get. He's comfortable throwing leg kicks. He will drive knees into your body. But it's the aggressiveness and the ability and willingness to stand in the pocket and trade that makes him truly, truly special. I think that is what separates kickboxers, the high level ones, from everyone else.
He understands distance as well as any striker in this division. Of course, that is a byproduct of a lifetime of repetitions in the kickboxing space. All right, well, he's one of the more accomplished strikers in this division. Sprawl and brawl, whatever you want to say, he's going to try to keep this fight standing tonight.
It does not matter how he accomplishes it. All he wants to do is be on his feet and at range, hitting you with a beautiful jab, staying away from the grappling exchanges. You don't accomplish all the things that this man has accomplished over the course of his career without understanding distance. He has great distance management, which then in turn allows him to land all these beautiful, diverse kicks, spinning back kick, jumping high kick, so many things he possesses that he will try to use tonight in this fight.
Yeah, if this turns into a kickboxing match tonight, most people believe his opponent is in a world of trouble.
And now our tail of the tape for this heavyweight fight. Both fighters are 18 years of age, with big differences in height and reach. All right, now for the particulars, here's Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the main event of the evening. And when the action begins, our referee in charge, Herb Dean. And now, this is the moment UFC fans around the world have been waiting for. Live from the sold-out Madison Square Garden Arena in New York City, it's time! Five rounds in the UFC heavyweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner. This man is a kickboxer, making his professional debut here tonight. He stands 6'5" tall, weighing in at 265 pounds. The Warrior! And now introducing his opponent, fighting out of the red corner. This man is a kickboxer, making his professional debut here tonight. He stands 5'2" tall, weighing in at 116 pounds. Iceman!
You've been given your instructions in the dressing room. Protect yourself at all times. Follow my instructions. We will have a clean fight. Touch gloves. Let's make it official.
They touch him up, and we are underway.
Ready.
All right, so we've got two classically trained strikers here. Any chance this fight actually goes to the ground?
This fight does not go to the ground. This one will be fought in the pocket. Two guys will stand in front of each other.
Oh, nice job to defend the takedown and scramble to his feet. Oh, really exploiting his reach advantage as he landed the jab there, DC. Single collar tie now, and they separate.
That's a big strike right there.
Well, perhaps a sign of things to come as he lands a kick there.
Nice kick landed by this gentleman.
Continues to mix it up, going to the head, mixing in some body shots.
Oh!
Somehow stays in the fight.
There's no tell on that leg kick.
Well, he absorbs a kick to the head here, left it wide open. He's got to not move into that power shot. Let's see if he can adjust.
Great timing on that beautiful.
Muay Thai club.
Big punch lands in the middle. Ooh, head kick lands perfect. Left hand punch in the clinch. Back in the clinch, look for him to hang on his opponent's head and try to wear at his gas tank. whip his hip into that kick.
Oh!
Holy smokes!
Well, these are some excellent ground and pound strikes here, DC. There's an efficiency with which he operates in these situations.
He knows exactly what to throw, exactly what to hold, and it's allowing him to really control the grappling aspect of the fight.
There's a song there, right? Know when to hold him, know when to hold him.
Yep, absolutely.
With the left there. Blocks that kick to the body.
Not only will this affect his ability to stand, but he can't really set down on his punches and he won't generate the power that he normally generates because he can't really get heavy on his leg. Look at him working at trying to shut the liver down. Nice kick.
And they separate. And he landed the right hand there. Well, he continues to stay busy, and he continues to land with volume punches here.
I mean,
oh!
He needs to start looking to finish now because he's got his opponent hurt very bad.
Wow! Oh, he dove and he lands. Wow! Oh, and that is it. Referee has seen enough, and maybe so have we. Your winner by TKO.
That was a great performance. Way to land those strikes and go and chase down the finish when you get an opportunity.
We'll take a look back at the highlights. You know we're gonna find that nasty head kick somewhere in this highlight rip. Just an incredible result for him here tonight.
A very nice head kick to finish the fight, but don't ignore all the work he did with his hands and give credit to the opponent. The opponent was in there every step of the way, and in order to get a fight of the night like you got tonight, both guys have to be willing to participate.
All right, the official decision is in. Here is Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Herb Deans called a stop to this contest at 4 minutes, 39 seconds of the very first round. Declaring the winner by knockout, the Warrior.
That's it. That's it.
Take down!